For this era, she's giving like very much fashion girl, I feel like, because she doesn't play by anyone's rules. Hi, Who What Wear, I'm Chris Moran, and today we're gonna be talking about some of Charlie XCX's iconic brat looks. So the Von Dutch music video, Charlie had this idea, like we're going to do a very like combative music video where like I'm in a fight. We shot it at Charles de Gaulle. It's the first music video to ever be shot there. And then the airplane scene where she's like on top and inside, that was filmed at an airplane museum. They had a not in service airplane. Charlie was really all about like the song. It needs to feel like there's a lot of speed and velocity and like chaos. We kind of knew it was gonna be this one look that would become severely disheveled. And so the tricky part for me was obviously I wanted it to be like extremely fashion and really cool. But at the same time, I was like, how are we gonna destroy like these really expensive pieces? I like thank Charlie again for doing this because the boots like were not comfortable, but I was like, these are the best looking boots. They were like these high gloss, flat riding boots from YSL, and I was like, I really do think it's gonna make a difference. The sweater is from Uniqlo, and we bought like, I don't know, 15 sweaters and just like distressed the hell out of them. Okay, so this look is actually kind of a funny way of how we got there. We were kind of putting together the looks on the fly, and then Imogene and Terry both were like, we really need something with color. I went up to Charlie's closet actually, and this is a Mugler dress that Casey designed, and it was just hanging in Charlie's closet and she had never worn it. And then we were like, this is perfect. So this look is from the Brits this past year, and it is a custom Marnie look designed by Francesco Risso. I had a strong feeling like from the jump, the minute I saw this look, and Charlie actually, like one of the few times where she's like, I don't really know, we'll try it on, like I don't get it though. We had a few other things that were like in transit that didn't make it yet. So we were kind of like, we feel really good about this, but we're still gonna try on other things, and then nothing ever compared to how great this look was, so it was done. This look is by this emerging or small designer, LaRucci. I kind of thought it was one of the more like tame looks of the 360 fittings that we did, but Charlie immediately on wearing it, like putting it on, she was like, I'm obsessed with this. I feel like I can strut. She was basically like, I want this to be like one of the main performance take looks, just because she felt so strong and like comfortable in it. This video was like a true experience in the best way. There's not very many music videos that are like fashion throughout the whole thing, and I just really wanted all of the girls to feel like themselves because they all do have such a strong sense of style. So I was just trying to like really make looks that they all felt like extremely hot and like excited to be a part of it. So that was like the whole goal. Okay, so this look is Charlie's Primavera headlining set look, and it is designed by Delara. I'm not gonna try and butcher her last name. And also there is a skirt by Alexandra Sipa that we had custom made in white. There are some specifics that she likes to make sure that we have in a performance look. Obviously being comfortable, having elements of movement are really important to her. Comfortable shoes, which is truly for me the worst part of making a performance look, because obviously I want like the highest shoe possible. This is the after party look from the Met, also designed by Marnie. It is all like hand painted. The shoes are also hand painted to look like the pattern on the dress. This is like the kickoff week of these Givenchy sunglasses that she now pretty much wears like all the time. I think they're her favorite ones currently. This look we kind of loved because it was a different silhouette for her. We kind of like snatched the waist even more. It has like a, again, bitchiness to it, but it still is like something different that you haven't seen her in before. Okay, so this is the Met Gala look designed by Marnie and Francesco. So this started by me sending them some ideas about what I kind of thought would be a really amazing look, and it was kind of based around time and something like being really deteriorated and beautiful. I had sent that this whole mood board, and then they came back with this amazing proposal that was deteriorated but t-shirts and a little more like punk aesthetic. Charlie and I both immediately were like, this is the one. This is actually one of my favorite looks from the first album press shoot that we did. So this was shot by Harley Weir. It is actually made up of these like little booty shorts from Cormeo. And the top is just like a Helmut Lang sheer top that I bought on Forward, to be honest. This look is during the Met week, and it's just kind of like a casual walking around look. It's by R13. The brat girl kind of does have a lot of nipple happening. It's like a balance of finding when it's appropriate. And so yeah, this is kind of just like a cute, distressed cardigan, baggy jeans short, and she was running to like, I don't know, some meeting. Okay, so this look is one of my favorites of all time, I think, with Charlie, and I think probably hers as well. It's a Jean Paul Gaultier archive look from the spring 2004 Couture collection. And this was for the Fashion Awards. We both were like, this is the look. Like, unless it doesn't fit, like, this is, we're both obsessed with it. From this era, what I'm most proud of are probably getting to be in this like environment where we all thrive and can come up with ideas and everyone's respected in like a very unique way that I think is actually really rare in this industry.